In this video, we're going to see how to draw Lewis structures. Now, a Lewis structure is a two-dimensional model, and it gives you some information, more information than just the formula does. So what you're going to see in this video is a procedure, so you should make sure you know how to follow this procedure, how to do it for any formula that you're given. So you're given a formula like this. We're going to use nitrate, NO3 minus, as our example to run through the procedure. Once you get a Lewis structure, by the way, it gives you the extra information it gives you that's different than just the formula, is it tells you the order of attachment, how the atoms are arranged, and it also tells you what kind of bonds, how the atoms are attached to each other. So first step is look at the formula and count how many valence electrons there are in the molecule. And if there's any negative charges, add one electron for every negative charge that there is. If there is any positive charges instead of negatives, take one electron away for every positive charge. And you're going to have to keep a running total of how many valence electrons you have, because we're going to use them up. So write it down and just keep track. Now, for nitrate, for example, a nitrogen atom has 5 valence electrons, a neutral nitrogen atom. How do you know? Remember, you look at the periodic table, and based on which column that element is in, you can tell how many valence electrons it has. So look at the periodic table, make sure you can see how we know that a neutral nitrogen atom has 5 valence electrons. So we write it down here. And oxygen, a neutral oxygen atom, has 6 valence electrons. Now, this subscript 3 means there are 3 oxygen atoms. So what we do here is we write down there are 6 valence electrons for each oxygen, times 3. That's this 3 right here. And because we have a -1 charge, we have to add one electron. So when we add all these numbers up, we get 24 valence electrons. That's the first step. Now the second step is just to arrange the atoms, okay? Lay them out on the table. And the way you do this is you find the least electronegative element, put it in the center, and arrange the other ones around it more or less symmetrically. The only exception here is that hydrogen can never go in the middle, always has to be one of the outside atoms. So it doesn't matter how, you know, even if it is the least electronegative element, it still goes on the outside. Otherwise, put the least electronegative element in the middle, the other ones around it. Next, we connect all the outer atoms to the central atom with single bonds. We represent a single bond as a single line, and remember, each line, each single bond contains 2 electrons. So for every line we draw, we have to take 2 electrons away from our running total of the valence electrons. So we had 24 valence electrons to begin with. We made 1, 2, 3 lines. Each contains 2 electrons. 3 times 2 is 6. So we subtract 6 from 24. And now we have 18 valence electrons left that we're going to still work with. So now we have that. Next step is we want to satisfy the octet rule for the outside atoms. Remember, the octet rule says that they want to have the same number of valence electrons as the nearest noble gas. And for oxygen, that means 8 valence electrons. So before we put any more electrons in, each of these oxygens here, it sees just the 2 electrons in the single bond that it's making to the nitrogen. So at this point, before we put any more in, this oxygen, this one, and this one each only see 2 valence electrons. So we need 6 more valence electrons for each of the oxygens to satisfy its octet. That 6 times 3 is 18. That happens to be just how many valence electrons we had left. So what we do is we put 2 dots on each side of each oxygen. Each dot represents an electron, a valence electron, the Lewis symbols, 2, 4, 6. So now this oxygen sees 2, 4, 6, 8 valence electrons, as do all of these. We've used up all of our valence electrons. We don't have any left. And that's a good thing. That's what we want to do. By the way, some notation here. These dots that we're putting out here, they're valence electrons. And if it's a dot on an atom, it's called a lone pair of electrons, or we usually just say a lone pair. If electrons are in a bond, we call that a bond pair. So we're going to distinguish lone pairs versus bond pairs. A pair is 2, right? So both of these make one pair. Next, if there are any valence electrons left, which there aren't, then we're going to put them all, whatever you have, put them on the central atom. At that point, no matter what, you should have zero valence electrons left. You have to. If you don't, something went wrong. Next. I'm going to check the octet rule for all the atoms. So let's do that. This oxygen sees 2, 4, 6, 8. So does this and this. That's good. But the nitrogen here only sees 2, 4, 6. It needs two more electrons. Well, we don't have any more valence electrons, so we can't just put two dots on here. That won't work. What we have to do at that point, if you've used up all your electrons and you haven't satisfied the octet rule for one or more of the atoms, what you do is you look for an atom that's attached directly to the electron deficient atom, and you look for one that has one or more lone pairs. And you take a lone pair, and what you do is you erase it, and you make it into a bond. It back. So we're going to make a bond here. So I took those two electrons from here, made it into a bond. This is now a double bond, and this oxygen here still sees 2, 4, 6, 8 valence electrons. So does this, and so does this. But now the nitrogen in the middle sees 8 valence electrons also. 2, 4, 6, 8. So everybody's octet rule is satisfied at this point. So when you get to this step, you have to make sure the octet rule is satisfied for all the atoms in the molecule. And finally, if there is a charge on the molecule, as there is with our example, then you put square brackets around that whole structure, and whatever the charge is, you put it as a superscript to the top right. So there we are. That is the Lewis structure for the nitrate polyatomic ion.